So this morning, Cape Town is super windy. What we're going to do is put the rock slider back, or the step, install our 90 liter fuel tank, which is quite heavy, so there's a couple of brackets and stuff like that, but yeah, we're going to see how it goes. But that's the plan for today. Fuel tank in, get the step back on, and happy days. Let's see how it goes. Here we are prepping the rock slider. She was bent. She needed some adjustments, some holes drilled a little bit bigger, and then we're going to try and refit it again.
This takes a lot of effort.
You're laughing.
You know when I'm gonna, whenever you're gonna say that, I'm gonna just tell you, welcome to my world.
Oh, where's Rob when you need him?
Salvage hunt, that is you. Ooh, does she fit or doesn't she fit? No, she doesn't fit. Definitely easier with two people. What a life, lying on the job. Like, hey, you think it just goes so easy on a video? Where? This is what we call in South Africa a skommel. When it's a bit of a mission. Okay, I think we're good. Okay, so we've just got this little bracket on here. The bolts in through the chassis. It was a two-man job, hence no video. And the bottom bracket's on. It's still all loose, but all we're trying to do is get the back up using a ratchet strap, and once it's all bolted in and all the hose clamps are on, then we're going to start buttoning it up and tightening it up, and I know she's going to be good to go. So let's get to the back here and see what happens. Okay, so this is the filler for the tank. The guys who put this in, I think the pipe is, I would have made the pipe this much longer, so hopefully we're going to steal some on the top here. Looks like we've got a bit extra, and then it's going to be, oh, happy days.
Oh, happy days.
So, we're just finishing a couple of things at the back end, doing some piping, all the bolts are shut. We just need to tighten them, and we're going to hopefully be done. So there she is, she's all in. We just need to make one bracket at the back, a little saddle bracket, because we didn't want to weld on the tank itself. So there it is. 1x90 liter fuel tank. Hence the ratchet strap. That's for where we need to make the bracket. Fuel pump pumps into the main tank. Happy days. Fuel tank's in. We did a good job. Woohoo! Oh, happy days. Yes, Monday morning. This is what got delivered to us. It's our spare wheel carrier for our 130. We've got the front runner one. Got a couple of pages of instructions. So we're gonna fit it and yeah, you'll see how it turns out. This is the bane of our lives, looking for a bolt. We suspect that there is a bolt short out in the border. So we're looking for another high tensile, 8 more bolts, so you know, happy days.
Are we missing washers as well?
I don't know. We think so. Because you're supposed to have, I think they say 10 big washers as spacers, but we only got these tiny little washers and these are just for the bolts and nuts. These are definitely not spacer washers. Always a bit nervous when you're drilling into your car. Fitted. There it is. It's our spare wheel carrier, done and dusted. It wasn't too bad at the end of the day, but we did have to find a couple of bolts and some spacers here. And there. Worked out pretty flush, quite happy with it. So yeah, another thing off the list.
And just approximately how many hours did that take?
This took about 5 hours. So yeah, probably an hour longer than the manual said.
Thanks for watching and we look forward to seeing you on our next episode. Don't forget to subscribe and join our adventure.